Hello and welcome back. I'm Sarah Maiga, your go-to real estate expert and associate broker of Maiga Homes with Keller Williams Ann Arbor. It's time for the next video in my latest series, Buying New Construction. Today, I'm going to be answering, will a builder negotiate when buying a new construction home? Now, we all know that new construction can be pretty exciting, and when you hear a new community is opening in your area, you'll probably race to go check out the model homes. Inside, you'll find beautifully staged furniture, ornate woodwork, custom kitchens, and large showers with Euro glass doors. It is hard not to think, I want to move right in. Well, that is why builders invest so much into their model homes, because it helps the buyer feel compelled to want to buy in their community, even though generally 85% of what you see in the model home is not included in their base pricing. Nonetheless, if you are deciding to take the plunge and sign a new construction purchase agreement, you should be aware that prior to the initial signing, generally you will only be choosing the following things: the home structural options, the lot and location, the exterior elevation, and the landscaping package if offered. Depending on the price of the subdivision and the builder you're using, because you'll still need to choose all the interior design selections, lighting, electrical, and security systems after the initial signing, you'll generally want to keep at least $30,000 to $60,000 in your remaining budget to ensure you have enough to make the house the way you want it. You would probably be pretty bummed if you max out your budget before a design studio and have to build a home with inadequate lighting or finishes that you really dislike. This is important because when we talk about the question, will a builder negotiate when buying in a new construction community? The answer is yes, but only before signing the initial purchase agreement. Once the builder has you locked in and signed on the dotted line, they will not come back later and give you a discount because you realize that the freestanding tub you want costs $3,000. With that being said, the best way to negotiate is to have a general idea of the design items you may want to choose at a later date and a rough budget for them. Knowing this allows you to come armed with better information to negotiate with the builder. This is mainly because the builder does not and will not want to negotiate on the price. The builder has a stake in keeping the sale prices high so that they can continue to do their quarterly price hikes and not hurt the value of the subdivision. So if you go to a builder and ask for money off the price, the builder is not going to agree. Generally, the builder is open to negotiations on the following items. Number one, discount off of your lot premium. Two, including a structural option like a sunroom or a full bathroom that would not normally be included. Number three, including an upgraded feature you know will cost you money down the line, like hardwood floors throughout the first floor or granite in all of the kitchen and bathrooms. Number four, a rebate or a certain amount of money back credited to you at closing, which means you have less money to bring to the closing table. Number five, a budget to allow you to spend a certain amount at design studio or allocate a percentage off of what you choose at design studio up to a certain amount spent. Please keep in mind that which strategies work and which ones don't will largely depend on the builder, the particular community you're interested in, and the experience of the agent you choose to work with as your buyer's representative. If you have an experienced realtor, they can help talk you through any objections you may have up front to see if what the builder is offering is reasonable or if there's any wiggle room. The key is to come armed with a plan for what you're asking for and a strategy for handling the conversations, as generally the sales agents are not the ones making the final decision. It's the construction or site manager that will be approving your offer. I've been able to negotiate many items, including a $10,000 signing bonus, an upgraded granite or hardwood floor in the main living spaces, a free finished basement, options off at design studio, $50,000 off a lot premium, credits to go toward closing, and design options included up front. If you think you're in the market to build a home, have an experienced and trusted agent on your side, not just to handle the negotiations, but also to be there as a partner should any issues arise that you are not expecting. And believe me, when you're building a new house, issues are likely to come up. I hope you learned a lot from today's episode and can see the value in having a realtor on your side to negotiate for you. If you have any questions about this topic or anything else involving real estate, reach out to me today, as I'd be happy to help and be a resource for you. In addition, I create custom moving plans for each of my clients up to a year in advance so that we can be fully prepared and partners in this real estate journey. So if you think you're within a year of making a move, reach out at the information below and set up a consultation. Plus, If I'm not able to personally assist you, I'm part of a global real estate company and can refer you to a similarly qualified agent anywhere in the world. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel today and tune in weekly to learn more about the process of buying and building a new construction home. Next week's episode will cover, when should I list my home on the market if I'm building a new construction home? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.